Come on, Mokha, up.
Girl.
Good morning.
How you doing, Mokha?
Yes. My name can be a drag, but we have a queen.
We got a queen here to help out.
Lipstick. You are working it, girl.
I'm not dance. I brought my red lipstick this morning.
You're going to give us some energy here on this Monday morning.
A lot of that.
Now, you're an award winner, too. You've gone in many competitions, won a lot of things along your years, right?
Yes, I have. I'm a former Miss Continental, National Talent of the Year, Miss Gay USFA, and Miss National.
That's awesome.
There you go.
An award winner in that.
And a lot of people probably recognize you from Kit Kat Lounge in Boys Town. Yes. You smell fantastic today.
Thank you very much.
I got to put that out there right now for those watching. You cannot. It smells fantastic.
Well, you have to come to the Kit Kat Lounge.
Absolutely.
I'll make sure you get 50% off, okay?
I was going to say, no.
All three of you guys, 50% off.
Can you do that to my tab that I had there on Friday night? Can you retroactively give me 50% off or no?
Let me see what I can do.
For those who haven't been to Kit Kat Lounge, can you give us an idea of what they can expect if they do go?
Well, when you come to the Kit Kat Lounge, you can expect a great entertainment. It's like a one-woman show. We make sure that everyone has a great experience, and we entertain every 15 to 20 minutes.
Oh, that's nice. So it's kind of sporadic throughout the whole evening. Yeah, that's fun.
You'll have awesome cocktails. It's like awesome entertainment, the music, the cocktails are really good, and it's just like a fun, flirty
time. We have a lot of martinis, and the cuisine is really good as well.
Yeah. All right, we're going to go check it out, especially since we got half off.
Yeah, absolutely. That's
half
a good sell.
Off, that's what it is.
Yep. Well, you can catch Mokha at the Kit Kat Lounge, as we said, in Supper Club at 3700. I'm not a math guy.
3700 North Halstead.
Okay, but hashtag love wins. This is my happy for them and everything along those lines. But hashtag love wins, that was something that the LGBT community was using as a rallying cry a couple years ago. This doesn't, I mean, for a Canadian pop star, I mean, come on, really using love wins?
Right.
I think his mother just want like a 15 minutes of fame right now, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Are you happy for him?
I'm very happy for Bieber. I mean, now I hope he's going to be a better man, maybe a father, and get himself together.
Oh, no.
And I'm a father.
Are we ready for that?
I didn't think about that.
Yeah, it's time. it's time.
I didn't think about that. I'm excited. At first, I was feeling like, okay, they're 21, 24, like a little young. However, I think when you're in Hollywood, you just age so much faster because you've done so much. Yeah. Think about that. So, he's been in Hollywood for over 10 years now. Right. He's been a household name. So, like, he's done a lot. He's seen a lot. He's been a lot of places. So, why not get married?
It's really interesting. For as critical as all of us have been about this one, it seems like both families are incredibly supportive. Billy Baldwin, the father of Hailey Baldwin, was the first one when the news came out that they were engaged, was uber excited about this thing. It just seems like both families are on board. Both of them seem to be incredibly happy. So maybe as fans watching or critics, maybe we should take a step back and embrace this one. It seems like it's got staying power.
Well, one thing I got to say is, you know, for people that love publicity, they certainly did it a little under the radar. You got to give them a little respect for not blowing under this big media circus.
Was he doing it for the green card, maybe?
What?
I mean, I'm just saying, a lot was to be made of him becoming an American citizen. Obviously, I'm saying it a little bit in jest, but that was a big part of what came from this. I don't know.
I'm sure. It's really hard to be in public eye, so maybe just want to, you know, find someone he really could relate to and settle down.
Right. Have you ever performed with a Bieber song by any chance?
No, I have not. Mm-hmm. Not at all.
Okay. Well, maybe this will be the new thing then.
So, Bieber fan or not a Bieber fan?
Some clean shade this morning.
I will be interested to see, as we did talk about the maturation, and Mokha, you led with that, it'll be interesting to see what kind of Justin Bieber we get moving forward, because he has reinvented himself at every turn. He was the young guy, the young kid discovered by Usher, who had these kitty bop songs, and then he became this guy with one of his most recent albums that dropped, and everyone's like, I don't like this guy, but I love his music.
Stuff.
Right. Let's see where he goes from here.
Yep.
It's not fair. This is totally political.
Mm-hmm.
The midterms are coming up. I think that's what they're making of this. He's an artist. He's going to, you know, touch many lives with his makeup skills. So let this young man be. Let's support him. And I hope the people at his school supports him.
One interesting thing is that he was wearing the makeup in part because it was part of cosmetology class.
Exactly.
So he's in a makeup class, and they do makeup on each other to practice for the career. And the girls get to keep on all the makeup they put on, but the boys don't. But I will say one positive thing. This is not a public school. This is an independent school district, so they can kind of live by their own rules. Mm. But there was a change.org petition that came out of this, and so many signatures were there that the administration did say, all right, well, if there is this much effort to make this change in the rule, let's sit down, let's talk about it. I've heard that before. before and nothing happens.
Exactly.
But let's see what happens. If we can have a positive conversation about this, maybe this will end up being a learning moment for everybody.
Yeah. So the other side of that, the more conservative side, I mean, I think the adults think that they are trying to steer this young person in the right direction so that they would be more socially acceptable and that they're going, you know, you want to put your children on the right path. So, I mean, do you feel like there's room for that, or at the end of the day, you just have to really just be, do what you want to do?
He should do what he wants to do. I mean, he's in the business of beauty. You have to promote. You have to sell products. You have to put it on, let people see you, and I think...
Yeah, I almost feel like this is a classic case of a state or an area that maybe has not been susceptible or experienced this before.
So, they're as red as her lipstick, I'll just say that. Exactly.
Well, that's a great point. I think right. I think ultimately the world we're living in right now, which I do think is something that we should embrace, is you got to be an adapt to change. And, right. and look, this wasn't a story in 1988. There probably wasn't a kid coming in that felt comfortable enough, although he existed, probably right. didn't feel comfortable enough right. to walk into his yeah. high school because it might have been life or death back right. then, depending on the landscape and the environment. Whereas now in 2018, there's a young man that feels confident enough to do this, and this should be something that's embraced. I have an 11-year-old child, and if he came to me, my little boy, and said, "Dad, I just feel more comfortable putting on makeup," well, the alpha sports dad in me may have to adjust to that, but right. it'd be something that ultimately, when put in front of my face, I would adapt to and adjust to. And I think that's what the world should do, and I think it's specifically Pearland, Texas needs to do that.
Well, what do you think about the more conservative side of it, though? People who feel that that might not be the best direction for their children or to be able to see that every day in school.
But is it fair to him? Because it's stopping him for doing what he really loves. I mean, it's a big deal about nothing. That's all. It right. really is because it's red state. Right. And they want to just make a big deal.
Let's take it back from Bieber. Hashtag love wins for him.
Love wins.
Absolutely.